Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a Q&A with my hubby.
Her co-worker.
Who has been literally in a cave for the past couple of months.
As you guys can see, looking a little rough here. Baby's taking a toll on us.
It's the new daddy look.
On us, huh? On me, actually.
I think he's just going for a daddy look. Like, he's trying to get that.
Try to embrace the change.
But we're excited to be filming this video. I know a lot of you guys have been asking me where Ulises has been, why he's not in any of my videos, why he's not in any of my vlogs. All the questions are gonna be answered today, but he is alive. Yes, and he is alive and he's well.
Well, let me see, back to when we found out about the baby. So we started, around that time. So it's weird. So like after I found out, you know, it took a little while to sink in, but after that, I kind of started thinking like, crap, you know, the baby's going to be here around July. I have to really start like focusing on what I want to do with myself. And it's weird. It's kind of like it gave me like a direction because I was kind of at a point where, you know, I have my shop, I work full time, but I was kind of starting to get tired of cutting because I was having problems here with time management, just because I already wasn't here at home as much. And then she started saying like, you know what, it's gonna be kind of hard because you're never home. So I was like, I need to make a change. So I started thinking, how can I make my business better? So I've been focusing on starting my own brand, which obviously is gonna generate some type of income as well. And I figured, you know what, it helps a lot of things out. So a lot of people have been asking about merchandise for myself, so I just been wanting to do it right. So I was like, I have to do this company basically from scratch. And what that's going to do is going to allow me to work from home. Obviously, you guys will be able to rock some of my merchandise and, you know, stuff like that.
A lot of stuff coming, yeah.
And then, so that was my main thing. So I was like, I need to focus on this. So I was kind of MIA just because of that reason. And then, you know, I still got a shop to manage. And
like you guys know, yeah.
Just planning.
He's a barbershop owner. He has a dream. He has his own goals. He has his own passions for what he does. And he's trying to build himself. And I think he was definitely trying to do that with the time he has right now that we have no baby. Because our lives are about to change. And I think he's definitely trying to be very involved. Like I mentioned, he's trying to take some time off of work when we, you know, have the baby. And it's like, he needs to make sure his business is running and everything is situated so he can take that time off to spend time with the baby.
So my main thing was like, I need to get two more barbers because we started getting busier at the shop. And like, I didn't want to deal with like trying to be taking care of like people when they come in. So I wanted to be, you know, make my business better. And then also I wanted to start my online business. So at least if I'm home, I could be productive too. And then just help out, really. I didn't want to be the same way I am right now because it wasn't going to work out as far as time management, you know? So,
and just being involved in general. Like, I told him, like, look, our lives are about to change and we need to adjust to things. And I need him to be 100% here with the baby and for both of us to equally put our parts. I wanted him to definitely have that time to spend with the baby because I can only do so much by myself, you know? We're both trying to run our business. We're both trying to be little entrepreneurs ourselves. And on top of that, now a baby's on the way. Yeah. So we need to be able to make sure that he's, that he feels comfortable enough to take that time off of work and be able to be here helping me when the baby is here. Because he doesn't want to miss out on those first couple of weeks, you know, crying
baby. Well, I didn't want to have to like be missing out on the baby growing and me not seeing it and stuff like that. So I was just like, you know what, I need to make these moves. And it's weird because like I always think like, what if we didn't have the baby? Would I really be like doing these things right now?
Feeling motivated at least? Yeah.
I mean, I would have had it in my head, but like as fast, who knows?
Yeah, it kind of just pushed you to...
Yeah, it pushed me. So I was like, shoot, before the baby's born, like I need to start my own company and I need to just expand my shop. So thankfully, everything's been working out so far. Everything seems on time, but these are definitely some crunch time weeks right now.
Yeah, but for those of you guys who were definitely wondering what he was up to and why, I think people were starting to wonder if I was a single mother, babe. You left me.
Just taken still, all right?
No, but you guys are definitely gonna see him like in my vlogs and stuff from after delivery. You guys will be seeing more of him. I hope if he doesn't hide and decide to go back into his cave, but. He just wanted to
stranded somewhere.
Yep, but he definitely wanted to just make sure that that was something that we addressed, you know, in the beginning, so you guys can know. But
so I've been working behind the scenes, basically. Is what it was.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I have a couple questions that they were asking. So one of the questions was, how does it feel to have such a sexy baby mama?
I'm jealous. I don't want his little friends at school one day to be like, damn, bro, your mom.
That's going to be me. That's going to be me.
Over there.
Babe, like, that's going to be me. I'm going to be that mom that, like, the friends are like, dude, that's your mom? And I'm going to be like.
And I'm like, I have to, like, work out and be hella buff and big by then. That way when I come out, I'm like, oh, shit, there's a dad.
There's a dad, huh? No wonder you get your good looks right now. I'm kidding. They're going to be like, these fucking cocky asses.
Nah, not even.
Oh, my God. No, that wasn't even a question. I just wanted to hear it, you know?
I can't tell you that right now in front of the camera.
I know.
I only tell you that in your ear. And I.
Okay. The next question is, what are you most excited about becoming a parent?
What am I most excited about? I don't know. It's weird. In the beginning, I didn't feel too much because I was just like, maybe later, but.
It doesn't seem real. I think it still doesn't seem real, though.
I mean, it's starting to. This last month has felt a little more real, but. I don't know. I guess like now that we have clothes and stuff like that, just like seeing them and then like the growing process, you know, you start thinking about different things that you wouldn't think about before. So I don't know. I guess I'm just excited about like
him, just the change him, period. And the transition.
Yeah.
And meeting him. You're just pretty excited because you think he's going to look like you, huh?
Well, we're hoping.
What is Lisa's most nervous and excited about when the baby arrives? Love you guys. You guys are going to make one beautiful baby. No pressure.
Nervous and excited. Well, we just talked about excited and nervous. I'm more nervous because...
We don't know what to expect.
I've never really, like babies are cool, but when they're really tiny, like, I'm scared. So maybe I'm just like... You know, it's so tender, like, I don't want
to,
like...
Yeah, he's probably going to be like, here, I don't know what to do. Yeah, and that's just normal. I feel like nobody's ever really ready. Yeah. Like, I don't think anybody's just like, I'm ready to have a baby. You know, I feel like it's always very unexpected. So I can definitely see where we could be nervous in that aspect of it. Who will be in the delivery room with you besides Ulises? Or will it just be you two? No, it's probably going to be Ulises, myself, and my sister, my oldest sister, not Viv, but the oldest one, just because she's very good with, you know, calming me down, and she's been in everybody's delivery room, so she's like that person that just knows how to be the midwives, like the ones that help you, and then, I mean, your mom, she's never really been in delivery rooms or anything like that.
I mean, she'll be there, I'm sure, but she probably won't be excited.
I don't think she probably would even... That's not even something we've ever talked about, but I think she kind of respects, like, the privacy, and she's probably, like, maybe not. My mom, there's no way I would even have my mom in the delivery room, because, she'll probably piss me off or, like, make me, I'm gonna be like, Mom, just get out of here. You know, since she's too emotional, she's gonna, like, stress me out, so I'd rather not even have her there. this is another question. Are you gonna be on birth control after the baby? So they already know how, like, we didn't get pregnant, you know, pull out game strong. So they're asking, are we going to be on birth control after? They say that once you pop out one baby, you need to be on birth control. So yeah, we're definitely going to be exploring some birth control options. Because
we'll see. That's what Joey say.
Ulises is ready for baby number two. He's already planning.
Not even.
He's already like, let's just go, babe. It's just
the pregnancy thing is like a big process. So I'm just like, I can't imagine the people, like, you got to get processed once I go back to back. Because it's like, damn, you're pretty much pregnant for like 2-3 years in a row. It's crazy.
Yeah. I think so. It's just the whole, and I feel like a lot of people too, there was a question in here that I saw that just in general, how I've been like with pregnancy and stuff. I feel like we've had a pretty smooth pregnancy. I don't think I've been crazy or anything like weird, like fucking emotional or anything like that. Have you been emotional?
I mean, not really, but
sit here and say,
not emotional, but
I was like, you can't say that I've been like an actual like crazy ass pregnant woman. I feel like she's been the same,
just sometimes like it's a little overboard with something.
My attitude probably is a little bit worse.
A little more short of temper.
Yeah, but other than that, I feel like shut up, you're dumb.
Pretty much. Beat see right ass. Now. See? Used to just be like, shut up.
No, I mean in general,
now
like
you threaten me.
Shut up. I'm talking about like in general, like with my pregnancy as far as like being hard to deal with or anything like that.
No.
Like I feel like we've had a pretty smooth pregnancy. I haven't been feeling like super crazy sick or anything like that. I have my moments. You know, but
there's days, yeah.
Yeah. I feel like I've been a trooper.
But
like,
then
I've
again
been
I don't see you in the mornings like that. So I don't know how you wake up type of thing, you know?
Yeah.
I only see you at the end of the day when you're ready.
I'm already exhausted, ready for bed.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, just as much as you guys haven't seen of him, I haven't seen of him either. Like, I literally just see this guy at night. And then whenever I do see him, we definitely try to like be there, and I'm not filming and I'm not trying to vlog because I'm trying to enjoy the moment that I am there with him. But I mean, it's been a smooth pregnancy. I just think I can't imagine myself being pregnant again, honestly.
That's what everybody says though, but it's
exhausting. It's tiring. A lot of people don't talk about the things that come. Babies are so cute and oh my God, and being pregnant. And it's like, we need to talk more about like all the emotional stuff that happens behind being pregnant, you know?
Yep.
And the scary moments. Yeah, and the stress. Like, we had a couple of moments where we went in transition. It was like literally every symptom that a pregnant woman feels, I felt. Like, in the beginning, it was like me being super sick, me sleeping like crazy.
And then we had our little, the baby was okay.
Okay, when we had our little scare. And then just worrying if everything's okay. And then my body changing. And then, like, just a lot of things happen. Like, transitioning has been probably the most difficult thing.
And then
thing.
Next thing you know, it's, like, 6 months. And you're like, oh.
Yeah, and you're like, shit, the baby's coming now. What do we do? You know? And, like, it literally flew by like this. I feel like it hasn't been that long. I don't feel like we've been pregnant forever.
Yeah, not really.
I feel like it's been such a short time.
After, like, six, it's just smooth after that. And then right now, this last month, you start feeling more stuff.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've been feeling, my body's just been, I'm uncomfortable, I'm a mess, like, right now. I feel like I can't sleep, and, you know, I feel bad. Like, I never even have him, like, try to, like, stay up too late with me either, because he has to work, and it's like, I'm there by myself, but it's crazy. Did you two already agree on circumcision?
I say don't circumcise.
Yeah, I had already told them that. He's team no, and I'm team yes, but... I think we need to like explore our pros and cons.
Yeah, but I don't know, for me, I'd just rather not.
Yeah.
That's just my thing. And then I'm just like, okay.
We actually were having this conversation recently with his parents and stuff, but I think we just really need to just sit down and actually take it serious and really figure out what we're going to do, but we'll figure it out. You guys will know what's going on. What has been the best memory you have while being pregnant? Honestly, I feel like we haven't even really been like... enjoying being pregnant, you know? Besides maybe Hawaii, like just the fact that we were relaxing, my baby bump was already there. I was already chilling.
I think that was like the first time we were like, oh dang, your stomach got big.
Yeah, like I think it in the beginning stages were like probably like the most exciting. I feel like we've both been so busy with work that we haven't even had... You have like
moments.
Ants in your pants, dude. You can never... Do you guys see how much he moves? Like, I can't even sit here and have a conversation with him because he's like fucking tying his shoe,
my
moving
back. Hurts
back.
Right now.
You're like a little kid. He's like ansioso.
My neck is itchy.
He's like, weird. Oh my God, relax. Sit. Okay. He's like fucking anxious as fuck. How do you feel overall about your pregnancy, and how did Ulises treat you? Did he change in any way? Love you guys both and wish you the best with this journey. I think he loves me more.
Yeah, a little bit.
I feel like he actually likes me a lot more now. I mean, he's always, like, believe it or not, you guys probably don't see the side of him, but he's a very affectionate person, and I'm not really that of, like, an affectionate person. He's more of the, like, he wants to hug me and kiss me and cuddle me, you know? And it's like, now it's like even more, you know? And then imagine you're being pregnant and it's like, you feel bloated, you feel fat, you feel like you can't breathe, you know? And it's like him, he wants to like hug me and kiss me and love me. And he's like, you're just so pretty. And he's rubbing my stomach. Like, he's more affectionate even like to another level.
Yeah.
Maybe but he's daytime, always been that way too.
So like, usually I don't bother her. Like,
yeah.
If she says stop. But
yeah,
I guess,
no,
at,
yeah,
night,
for
I guess
sure.
At night I like
he knows me very well. Like, he knows to like, if he already sees that I'm like in a bad mood or something, he's like, let me just not even talk to her. But at night, definitely he's trying to like, you know, rub my belly and hug me and love me, but mm-hmm. He likes me more now. So he did change. He got even nicer now that I'm pregnant. Are you still gonna love me after the baby's here, or are you just gonna love the baby?
I don't know, it's too far to tell. Let's see.
Who has more cravings, you or Ulises? Did he gain any weight, lol?
Let's get to that then. I thought I didn't. And then I took a picture and I was like, dude, what the fuck's going on?
You know what, but he's already been gaining weight before even I got pregnant, because he was always very skinny and he was very insecure about that. So he's always wanted to like
put some good weight on.
Yeah.
Really weight, yeah, and in turn.
But he has definitely been taking advantage of the fact that I'm pregnant.
But it's weird because I'm going to the gym more now. Like, maybe because in my head I'm like, shit, I'm not trying to get fat or like lose this routine, so I want to keep going. But you know, it's really just for eating bad. I think that's about it. But cravings. I don't say I crave something like, damn, I want a hot dog right now. But like, let's say somebody says, oh,
Some tacos would sound good.
Yeah, and then like now it bothers me.
Thinking about tacos. Yeah.
So I want to go get them now. And if I don't, it bother me. So I'm like, shit.
Yeah. So, but see, he's always had a really good appetite and a very fast metabolism. So regardless, like he for how he eats, he actually hasn't gained as much weight as he probably should.
Yeah, think about it. If I didn't have the fast metabolism, I'd be fat for sure.
Yeah, he probably, because he has been eating a lot, but he definitely has felt a lot of my symptoms. So I feel like in the beginning when I was really tired, he was really tired. You know, when I started getting some cravings, he kind of started feeling the cravings. So I do believe that
in some
aspects of it, they do feel what we feel for sure. Has the pregnancy changed your marriage? And if so, how did it? I don't think it's changed us.
No. I feel like it probably made me be a little bit better, like, responsible-wise.
Responsible, yeah.
Like, maybe be a little more at the house, take care of things longer. So.
Yeah. It definitely changes your perspective, yeah, to... You kind of have a reason now. It's like, not that you didn't before, like, marriage wasn't enough, but you see a different light.
Yeah, it's weird, because, too, like the other day I was... So, we have the actual big jugs of, like, water.
Mm-hmm.
So, I put it in, and then, like, some fell, and, like... Maybe before I'd be like, whatever, I'll clean that later. But like now I'm like, fuck, what if Blanca slips? Let me clean it. Yeah. So it's like, I'm more aware. So obviously if we have the baby, you know, once we do.
Makes you a little bit more cautious.
Yeah, I'll be like, shit, like maybe let me not put that there. Yeah. Like, what if she walks in and slips, you know, something like that. So.
Yeah. And you guys already know guys in general, I'm sure they need to be told 100 million times to do things. I'm sure that's every single man. But the fact that he's actually being a little bit more cautious and caring about me and the baby, it's showing a lot that those fatherly instincts are starting to kick in.
Yep.
But most of the questions were pretty basic. I think we just kind of wanted to come on here and I wanted to do the video so you guys can kind of get his input on things, because you guys only see me on camera all the time and how I'm feeling, but I'm not in this by myself. I didn't make this baby by myself. But I'm glad you guys were able to kind of see a little bit of Ulysses and how he feels. He hates when I call him Ulysses.
Yeah, hopefully you guys get to see my side of it, and I think I pretty much explained everything, honestly.
Yeah.
I don't think I
But we're both very excited, yeah. Whether you guys see it or not, you know, I know you guys, a lot of you guys think that Ulysses doesn't have very much emotion, but he's a sweetheart. He loves me and he loves this baby, and he's excited, and we're both excited for this new journey that we're about to endure with this little troll of ours.
Only a few weeks away. It's crazy.
I know, it feels like it's happening so fast for us, but I can't wait, and I can't wait to bring you guys along with this journey and you guys meeting our little baby. And we're gonna make sure that we try to capture and record as much of the moments, you know, once the baby does come.
Yep.
Yeah, but yeah, we're excited.
He's already famous.
I know. Everybody loves him. I swear. I feel like he's not even born yet. And I've been getting so much love from like all my girls. Like, oh my God, we can't wait to meet him. And
yeah,
he's already so loved by so many people.
It's pretty crazy too to be like, we go to your seminars and all this stuff, and now it's like we have a baby. It's like, oh shit.
Yeah. You guys are seeing our lives just change. I mean, you guys have seen us from boyfriend and girlfriend to getting married to now starting our family. So it's nice for us to be able to capture this, and even later on in the future, you know, the baby will be able to see this video and we'll be able to show it to him and see how our journey was with mom and dad and all that fun stuff.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
So it's cute.
That's cool.
We're excited, but I hope you guys all enjoyed this video. Thank you guys all so much for watching, and we will see you guys on our next video. Love you guys.